Hello friends, warm greetings from Ekalavya Academy. We are going to see about the digital initiatives in higher education, part 3, E-SHODHSINDHU. It is the initiative of Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. It is being executed by InflipNet Center. Then it provides access to e-resources to universities, colleges and centrally funded technical institutions in India. Then, based on the recommendation of expert committee, the Ministry of Human Resource Development has formed E-SHODHSINDHU, merging the three consortia initiatives, namely UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortium, NLIST and Indus AICTE. Then it provides current as well as archival access to more than 15,000 core and peer-reviewed journals and a number of bibliographic, citation and factual databases in different disciplines from a large number of publishers and aggregators to its member institutions, including centrally funded technical institutions, universities and colleges. The next one is, who gets benefit of E-SHODHSINDHU consortium? Faculty, research scholars, students of centrally funded technical institutions, universities and colleges. Then the next one is, who pays for e-subscription under the E-SHODHSINDHU consortium? The Ministry of Human Resource Development funds the entire expenses for centrally funded technical institutions and UGC funded universities for providing the e-journals access to participating institutions. Then AICTE funds for engineering resources for government engineering colleges and universities having engineering departments or faculty. The next one is, what is the subject coverage of E-SHODHSINDHU consortium? The consortium covers all the discipline, pure science, engineering and technology, social science and humanities, including management and language. Then abbreviations used in the context. NLIST means National Library and Information Services. Indus means Indian National Digital Library in Engineering, Science and Technology. Thank you, friends.